Time for another Ask Dirk segment, something we wait for the entire week. And today you're talking about Arctic hurricanes?
Yes, that looks like a hurricane, doesn't it?
Or a cyclone.
I think so, it does. Looks like you can see the eye right there.
The eye right there. Yeah. It looks just like a hurricane, but actually it's not. Our question comes from Valerie Jones. She doesn't say where she's from, but she says, what is an Arctic hurricane, and can this type of weather occur off the California coast? Well, this is actually an Arctic hurricane. Technically, it's not a hurricane. It's actually a polar low is what the more scientific term is, but it looks an awful lot like a hurricane. And this one was actually a picture taken just to the north of Russia, so it's in the Arctic Circle is where this was occurring. But what is an Arctic hurricane? Let's go ahead and take a look at this. Arctic hurricane, of course, it's going to be happening. If you think of Arctic, you think of cold things that are going on. And so what you need to have a couple of ingredients here. You need to have cold polar air, and then relatively warm sea. You know, if you're out here in the Gulf of Alaska, you're not going to want to go bathing, you know, sunbathing or anything out there. It's pretty chilly, so you don't want to touch the water. But relative to the air, it's actually a little bit warmer. And so what you need is that cold polar air to come out over the water. And as that occurs, you start to get some convection. And this is where it's actually similar to a hurricane. What you need is, of course, that warm, moist air in a hurricane to start some convection, make that into a storm. And that's what happens here. Again, it's still cold, but we do have some convection. We start to get that storm, and it intensifies and eventually get this shape that looks like a hurricane out over the water. Now, with the Arctic hurricane, the sizes are similar to regular hurricanes, anywhere from 250 to 500 miles as far as the size of these weather systems. Winds also can be similar. We're looking at winds typically in the 35 to 50 mile per hour range, but you can have Arctic hurricanes that get up to 100 plus miles per hour. Now, where we really differ, not only with the cold temperatures, but also it's the duration. How long do these storm systems last? And they don't last very long. Anywhere from 12 to 36 hours is all that they last. And they're pretty hard to forecast for. It's hard to detect when they begin and when they end. In fact, they can hit and then they're gone within a 24-hour period. And sometimes you don't even know what happens. In fact, before they started taking the satellite pictures, they think that a lot of ships may have been lost at sea because of these very storms.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Now, the areas where this occurs, you can see my little ring here. It's basically around the Arctic Circle. Any of those areas of water, that's where you can have an Arctic hurricane or a polar low develop. Some of the more common names, the Gulf of Alaska, the Labrador Sea, the Nordic Seas, as well as the North Atlantic, the Barents Sea, and the Sea of Japan are all locations where we can see an Arctic hurricane develop. Again, it's a polar low, but it looks an awful lot like a hurricane.
So the answer to her question is no, not here in California.
Not here in California, but because we can't have one here physically, we can actually help us along with making our own Arctic hurricane.
So
what I did this morning,
yes.
I've spent all morning churning and churning and churning, just like an Arctic hurricane, and this is the result. We have our Arctic hurricane.
Yeah.
I know, Eileen. This is why Eileen got into science right
First
here.
Day of spring, and we get
churning, and we've got ourselves some ice. Now, this is very similar to an Arctic hurricane. One, it takes
Does it
cold,
taste the
cold.
Same?
I don't know. Find out.
Right.
You need some very cold conditions, of course, for them both to develop. Also, there's a lot of churning involved. Of course, with the Arctic hurricane, you have those winds blowing, and here you've got the churn that's blowing and stirring things up. And probably the third thing that's very similar between these two is that it doesn't last very long.
That's good, though.
Well, this will certainly not last long in the studio.
How many questions are you getting now? I mean, we share email all the time. You're getting
quite a few questions that are coming in, and it's just a matter of how many. You know, we can only get one in a week, and so what I'm going to try to do is try to answer them online. Eventually, we'll be able to go on there, and they'll post those answers, and so you'll be able to get those answers online and see the answers to all of your questions. So if you have a question, go ahead and get online, kcra.com/morningnews. There's a section there. Go down. You see Ask Dirk. You can get on there, ask your question, get it to me, and I will try my best to answer it.
Now you do a great job of demonstrating this, and food is always a nice way to do that. In case you missed this segment or you just want to watch it again, you can find the videos here as well. It's all at kcra.com/morningnews.